I hate winter. It's cold, it's gray, it gets dark so dang early. Turns out your body hates it too. Hey guys, Julia here for D News. Winter is rough for those of us who live in cold climates. As the wind chill dips below 0 degrees, you ask yourself, why do I live somewhere where the air hurts my face? But it's not just the cold that's rough on our bodies, it's the lack of sunlight too. Almost all living things have a circadian rhythm that changes with light. From sleep cycles to hibernation, light regulates most of life on Earth. The Earth is tilted at a comfortable 23.5 degrees. This means that at some parts of the year, the northern hemisphere leans slightly closer to the sun, and at other parts of the year, the southern hemisphere gets a little cozier with the sun. And with that, it means the amount of light that reaches your little section of the planet changes throughout the year. Those gray skies and fading evening light can have profound changes on your body. The change in light can cause problems like seasonal affective disorder, a condition which brings about a low mood as levels of sunlight-induced vitamin D drop. But there's a few other lesser-known effects of less sunlight. In a study published in the journal Drug Metabolism and Disposition, researchers found how less sunlight changes how your body metabolizes medication. They focused on two types of immune-suppressing drugs, tacrolimus and sirolimus. Basically, the more vitamin D, the more an enzyme, CYP3A4, is produced. The more of this enzyme, the faster the drugs are metabolized. While the study focused on just these two medications, the researchers think that these results might be true for other types of medications. So the study suggests that sunlight could affect your sensitivity to certain drugs. And another study from the American College of Cardiology found that cholesterol levels vary from season to season. In a large study of over 2.8 million adults, researchers from Johns Hopkins Ciceroan Center for the Prevention of Heart Disease found that for many people, cholesterol levels seem to be higher in the winter. The researchers think that less sunlight plays a role in these rising levels. As we are exposed to less light during the winter because of staying inside or shorter days, we get less vitamin D. Another study published in the journal Menopause found a link between more vitamin D and lower cholesterol levels. So with less vitamin D, cholesterol levels might rise. But even though more research is needed here, there's other evidence that shows how your body takes a whopping in the winter, so much so that it affects your genes. One study published in the journal Nature Communications found that around 23% of human genome expression changes from season to season, mostly to boost your immune system. This time of year is prime cold and flu season, so to fight off infections, your body switches on certain pro-inflammatory genes. Your DNA is made up of two strands that wrap around each other in the famous double helix structure. To get even more compact and tiny, that DNA is wrapped around little proteins called histones. Think of how thread is wrapped around a spool. That's kind of what histones look like. When DNA needs to be translated to make proteins, these histones unravel to let out a little bit of DNA at a time. But which histones unravel when depends on various influences. In this case, it's seasonal influences, probably, again, the amount of sunlight. When the participants went through winter months, no matter what hemisphere they were in, the lack of sunlight seemed to activate these pro-inflammatory genes. And like we know from other D News episodes, inflammation, while it can help us fight off some infections, too much can also harm our health, leading to heart disease, diabetes, or stress-related mental health issues. Which, interestingly, the authors think this inflammation could also be another reason for more cardiovascular deaths in the winter. But if you live somewhere where there isn't a winter, your immune system is impacted by other kinds of seasonal changes. In this study, the researchers found that those who live in Gambia have seasonal peaks correlated with the rainy season, which is June to October, when infectious diseases seem to be more prevalent. So, happy winter to everybody who's in it. Enjoy your body's changes. I hope this season brings you more joy than it brings cardiovascular, psychiatric, or inflammatory issues. Or maybe if you wait long enough, climate change could take away our seasons, starting with fall. To find out more about the end of autumn, Trey says the scoop in this episode right here.
The warmer fall of the future will cause trees' leaves to stay greener longer and then drop early, shortening how much time we can actually enjoy it. Plus, temperature shifts let more insects move north, attacking trees that may not have been exposed to them in the past.
So are you a fan of winter, love to build snowmen in the frozen outdoors? Are you a curl up by the fire with a good book kind of person? Tell us your thoughts down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons so you don't miss a single episode of D News.